Factious, fractious, factitious, excoriate, execrate, or exhort, or extenuating circumstances, contentious, sententious, tendentious, impertinent, unnerve, undermine. Aren't you familiar with the following 12 words? So please stay tuned. Welcome back to English with Marina. And I would like to tell my idea of the English language. Yes, from time to time it's great to keep in mind the idea of dolce far niente, as would be said by the Italians. But nevertheless, no pain, no gain. And therefore, I suggest being some kind of exposed to really ravishing words that are really useful in our everyday life, and also they're really useful while preparing for the GRE verbal section. So, let's tune, let's begin, let's commence. The word number one, factious. Factious. Factious related or inclined to dissensions. Everything that causes factions can be called as factious. However, you are supposed to keep in mind that this adjective, factious, cannot be used when we describe people. But, for example, you're probably familiar with the current political situation in the Ukraine. So therefore, it's a great example to say the Ukraine is considered to be a factious country. Idea number one. Oh, my apologies. Idea number two. Fractious. Fractious. Someone is fractious, he or she is irritable, quarrelsome. So therefore, it's really word number one, option number one, when we describe someone who is pugnacious, who is contentious. So therefore, Zhirinovsky is considered to be a fractious individual. Factitious. Factitious. That this is the tricky word is definitely to say the least. And when I preface this word to be as a tricky, you can bet that the definition of the word is not exactly how it sounds. So therefore, something that is factitious, it means that it is artificially created or artificially developed. For example, this excitement on Instagram was factitious as well as confined to some kind of media, or a largely factitious national identity. So I would like you to memorize the following. When we use the following adjective, for example, bogus or fake or phony, instead of simply saying them, you're very welcome to say factitious. Factitious, something that is not real. All right, so the word number four, excoriate. Excoriate. To yell at someone is one idea, but to excoriate is a whole other. For example, a martinet of a boss, whom once again you are upset, or a drill sergeant berating, scolding his feckless, smirking recruit. Now we're closer. Criticize really, really harshly is to excoriate. Interestingly, the second definition of this verb, excoriate, means to tear one's skin from his or her body. So therefore, to verbally excoriate, figuratively speaking, is to rip off one's skin. Keep in mind, instead of simply saying excoriate, or instead of simply saying, I would say, criticize, you are very welcome to use other synonyms. For example, upbraid, she upbraids me. Reprimand, she reprimands me, or reproach, or castigate, or some kind of chide. These ideas should be kept in mind. Alright, so the word number five, execrate. Execrate. I would say that this word just sounds awful, execrate. However, I have the really great news for you. Execrate means the very same like it sounds, so it is really consistent with the way it sounds. When we say that someone is execrating someone, he or she feels or expresses great loathing for. Just try to imagine the following situation. So, for example, our favorite American football player decides to leave his old team so that he could gain more money with another team. Definitely, fans are going to execrate him for his mercenary mode. And also, I would like you to memorize the following adjective, execrative, execrative, because this adjective is commonly used in GRE verbal section. Alright, let's move on and let's focus on the word number five, exhort. Exhort. Exhort means to strongly urge on, to encourage. And you probably know that encourage meant, the encouragement itself means for something positive. So therefore, your mentor figure will exert you to make the most of your life, while mercenary or miscreant, some kind of will cajole you into doing something really you will definitely regret after. So, you also, I have prepared the following word for you, extenuating, extenuating. And I would say this adjective can be really applicable when we describe some kind of circumstances. No secret, therefore, this adjective is a common courtroom lingo. So, you can say extenuating circumstances, extenuating circumstances. Imagine the following. So, someone broke into a drugstore in order to steal some kind of exorbitantly priced medications. Later we will discover that these expensive, exorbitantly priced medications were supposed for his wife. So therefore, we would probably guess that these circumstances are going to be extenuating. So extenuating, by the way, means to make less guilty as well as more forgivable. Alright, so the next word is going to be tendentious. Tendentious. So, tendentious means to expose to controversially point of view. So, great example of a tendentious is being biased. However, when you are biased, you are not necessarily leaning towards really controversial idea. So, therefore, you can say tendentious reading of history. Tendentious reading of history. Sententious. Sententious. This is a great adjective when we describe, for example, either people or some kind of documents. So, something that tries, or someone who is so trying so hard to be wise, to be smart, intelligent, but it's so irritating nevertheless. We can say that he or she is too sententious, or this document was really sententious to read. So, therefore, I didn't like to read it. Another word is going to be the following, controversial. Controversial. I love this adjective simply because, once again, you can describe some kind of ideas, debates as controversial. So it means controversial, so, right? Contentious collocations. So these debates were contentious. These ideas were contentious. When we describe a person, we mean that he or she really enjoys arguing. Therefore, contentious has come from not the following, content, be content, so to be, to express agreeable to something, right, idea, but no, actually it means to contend, it means to argue. So therefore, Rylinovsky once again can be described as a contentious individual. So, the following idea, impertinent. You would probably say, okay, impertinent is going to be something like opposite of pertinent. Well, I can totally relate to it, but unfortunately, this word is not so commonly used. So therefore, when we say that someone is impertinent, we mean that he is churlish. So he doesn't express, I would say, respect when this respect is really needed. So therefore, someone who is impertinent, he behaves bad. Number 11, undermine. When we undermine someone's authority, it means that we weaken someone's authority. For example, a student undermined the teacher's authority while questioning every own his judgment. And the very last word is going to be unnerve. Unnerve. Unnerve doesn't mean to make less nerve. No, it means the opposite. When you unnerve someone, you some kind of disconcert toward what he is about to fail. So therefore, you unnerve. For example, you can say that I can be from time to time unnerving, right? Or the circumstances are also going to be unnerve to me. Right. I hope that this lesson had a productive for you. I hope that you learned something. I hope that it was enjoyable for you. Please don't forget to check these exercises for checking your understanding of the following 12 words that can be used while preparing for GRE. Let's call it a day. It has been a pleasure to have been talking to you about these 12 commonly used words in the GRE section for about 10 minutes. So thank you for having watching that.